Maddox, you must be so proud. The bears and the Arctic foxes and all of the predators and everybody else may try so hard to eat your babies, but their teeth will merely bounce right off of them, just like no one can really attack you either. Ah, hello everyone and welcome to the Akir tribe, where we are still celebrating the fact we are starting to really fold that amazing armored body gene deeply into the family tree with the birth of Maddox's very first daughter, little Korra. And I love that she just automatically came with the name Korra, because I do love Avatar the Last Airbender, and she was born in really icy regions and was super strong too, so I'm going to be keeping that name for her. But I love it, she also has the ram horn, which means she has a little bit of a attack, and that's going to help out if she ever needs to bump into a rabbit or something like that. But when you've got the armored body, you don't really have to worry. Oh my, look at the bird right there. Just kind of lurking over our tribe, are you, bird? Very, very close of you. Kind of visiting a little bit closely, don't you think? You can't have my new baby. The birds are the only thing I'm really worried about when it comes to the new armored bodied babies that we're having being attacked. So I'm going to have to keep an eye out on that. But this is fantastic, because I don't think Maddox went head to head with the balance bear multiple times and it couldn't do any damage to him. So this gene, I kind of was like, oh, we didn't get one of the really cool looking genes when we first bumped into it, when we had just like a fluffier armored looking body, but it's turning out to be phenomenal. It protects us so much. We just must have like fur that's like Kevlar, so I'm super happy about it, and hopefully Maddox will have lots and lots of children. That's going to be our goal today, is basically having tons of babies with him and his sisters, which again is a little weird, but you do what you have to do to be able to get the genes that you're really going for. And we will be gathering up food with the rest of our creatures and trying to preserve some of the rare immunity genes to send on to the next island for when we go searching for more of the hidden genes amongst the ice. So without further ado, time for another baby. Hopefully we'll have twins. Nasi. Wonderful. Pregnant. Right away. We're going to be jumping little Rara, who is the other mate that Maddox is going to be taking on over here, building her a nest. Boom. Immediate babies. That makes me very happy. And Winty is having a hard time. She's a little bit alone, so we're gonna send Avar over. Winty and Avar are kind of like a team. Winty helped Avar out so long ago when he was a young child, covered in leeches. His mother had just passed away, and even though Winty can't ever see Avar because she is our only blind creature, she is taking very good care of him, and they are very loyal friends. We have also started releasing a whole bunch of our creatures from our tribe that we just know aren't really going to contribute genetically, because I know we're gonna have so many babies. I can't even attack that bunny. Oh, that's so frustrating. And actually, the balance bear is right around the corner somewhere nearby. Oh, there he is. Look at his eyeballs. That's so cool. So hopefully the balance bear won't come over here and threaten my nest area. And oh, I think there's enough creatures. Yes, there's enough creatures that the pack is going to stay warm even though the snows are coming in the blizzard. So that makes me pretty excited too. All right, little Rodin is one of the siblings of the family, and I think I'm gonna have him come down and gather up some of this and just kind of keep an eye on things over here. He's not going to be one of our main breeders, though it might be useful to try breeding him with maybe one of the children born, like Korra. We'll have to see. I need to bring the immunity genes in, but I don't want to lose the armored body. That's kind of one of my big things. Harvey is going to be scooching over because he is on the lookout for love. And here's little Kirku, who's now free to do all the wandering he wants. Like I said, we have been releasing a lot of the creatures from our tribe, not because I don't like them, but because it's kind of fun to see them do their own thing. There's not enough berry bushes that we really have to worry about them stealing food, and then I don't have to worry about them taking food from our pool for our tribe. But let's see, Harvey is supposed to have a romantic date with Mooney because we need to keep that immunity K gene alive, and they've got some good treats they could share. No, you can't steal, Kirku, you can't steal our food. All right, so we're gonna have her come over, and Mooney and Harvey have finally, across the ice, met one another, and they've awkwardly got Lassie watching them. And Lassie we've actually been bringing over because I'm hoping to have her be a good mate with Zakai. I think that they would make a pretty good set. Oh, and then no, you can't have any of this. I'm sorry, Kukir. We made that clear. And then Kinka is really cool too, but I don't know what I'm gonna do with her. I'm having her just search out for some clams at the moment. And clams aren't really abundant here. It'd be cool if you had kind of like a beach, savanna, grassland island that could spawn, and it was like covered in clams and waterfalls and was more like an oasis place than anything else. Really good for water body and like duckbills and things like that. All right, let's see. We do have little Darren, who I am kind of keeping around because he has the G&D immunity gene. But actually, if I think about it, Fisk is actually better to keep because he has the H and D immunity gene, and those are both rare. So he's going to be given the little blue icon of interesting genetics that I want to keep an eye on. And I may release Darren then because he is really cool and he has really high fertility. And that D is awesome, but that H is uncommon for this side of the family. Let me double check. Yeah, I don't think we have H in the armored bodied creatures. And yeah, so I think we'll release Darren. Sorry, Darren, it's not personal. I just have to be really, really picky about what we're doing. So I'll have to move him down and have him gently escorted away by one of our alphas, Zakir. And then Zakir, I wonder if I'm gonna have Zakir move. And let's see, Lamila is right here. Can you rebuild the nest? I'm that low on nesting material? When did that happen? This is critically not good. Okay, Fisk, you need to start helping collect nesting material. Now I know what I'm gonna be doing with some of my strays. And then Raiju just had a daughter, that's right. Raiju and Lamila, who unfortunately won't be able to build a nest in time, just had a daughter, Anna Riri. And we're gonna name her, let's go with Sedali, because she is very beautiful, and we'll keep her around. Gosh, she's so lovely. If only we were going for genes that were just beautiful, I would keep quite a few more of our creatures. But darn, I was really hoping that Raiju and Lamila would be able to have more children, but without a nest, I mean, I don't think I can get her in a nest in time. I didn't realize the nesting material had run that low. Huh, maybe I'll have him wiggle over this way. All right, let's see. There's a bunny. Yes, got some food here. And then Katami is gathering up stuff over here. Let's see, berry bush is empty. Gather up from the berry bush with Griana here. And then we'll gather up some of the regrowing grass. Yeah, it's gonna take us a while. I didn't realize that we had run so tremendously low when it came to some of our resources for food. Tagai is really cool, or resources for nesting material. Tagai is going to walk around, and he's a really good digger, and I think he's just really cool. I think Tagai is awesome. He's going to be searching the mountainside and gathering up all sorts of cool roots, so we'll work with him too. All right, good. I think that covers everybody pretty much. Let's see, we'll gather up some of the grass here. I guess we're just super low on nesting material in general. That is not very good. Well, let's have you move over here. We'll have to gather up. Oh, there's the spots that we can gather up nesting material here with special little bushes. I'll have to send some of our creatures out there to kind of keep an eye on them. But all right, let's see if we have more armored bodied babies. Please, please, please be armored body. One little girl. Big body, dang it. And big body on the boy. Why? Oh, why? But they're all healthy at least, so I should be very grateful for that. So little Kuniro, I'm going to give him the name of, let's go with, let's see, Kurodo, and then let's go to some of your guys' newer name suggestions. Let's name this little one, Aridra, that's such a beautiful name. There we go. And unfortunately, no armored body. Dang it! All right, but we have an armored bodied female. I don't want to have to mate her with her dad. That would be like the most awkward thing ever. But push come to shove, I've got to do what I've got to do to keep this going. Maddox is going to step over here. What do we have to collect? Oh, that's just clearing away the snow. I was hoping one of those cool bushes was there. No, get back in the nest, Rusty. You need to have another baby. Like, stat. Oh, thank goodness. And I actually need another nest, so I need to start gathering up nesting material. This is pretty critical. I finally had all these different pairs meet who could possibly have babies. Oh, and I can actually repair the nest and have enough that I think Lamila can have one more baby. Out of the way, little one. All right, Lamila, repair the nest, jump into it, and you can have one more baby. Oh, that's so good. Hey, and back off, buddy. Stealing my little like nuts from our tree. Very rude. All right, there we go. Whew. So yeah, I need to gather up some of this nesting material. I hadn't realized that things had gotten that critical for some of our tribe. And let's have Lassie. Do we have any of the, no, none of the bushes I can use. Have her. Whoa, who just got pregnant? Excuse you? Hello, hello? Oh no. Truly? That's your dad though, Griana. Oh dear. Like that's literally, you care as her father. That's very awkward. Very awkward indeed. All right, let's see. Let's gather up this. Why are all the permanent nests on the wrong side of the island for us? I'm gonna move Snowflake around to see what else she can collect. And I'm actually gonna have Griana. I wonder what happens if you let a pregnant female become a rogue. We're gonna try that out. So I'm gonna release her. And then I'm gonna start gathering up. Oh, there is food there? I'm gonna start gathering up a ton of the food and the grass from over here with Katamai. And then I think that I actually saw, yeah, there's a root there. And there's a root over here, and there's a bush to collect up from over here. So we're getting a little bit stretched on some of our resources, like very specific resources. Which means, Darren, could I use you to possibly go find more of those bushes. Bushes, one bush over here. I know there are a whole bunch of them like over here that I kept bumping into. So Darren, you may have been given a reprieve from being released because I'm going to use you to find some bushes. And then Mooney, are there anything she can dig up over here? Not really. Mooney and Harvey have finally met. I'll go ahead, let her become pregnant. Oh, there's a bunny in the hot springs. Can I get it? I think I can. Sweet. And then there you go. Just managed to get her a good snack. So wonderful. Ooh, and sorry about the lag. I think it's because of the snow. I have a really, really, really good computer, but it's just, you know, experimental versions, experimental issues. All right, we might have Draju try to gather up another one of the, another spot of the grass. And Fisk is kind of, yeah, he's kind of my best bet for some of our rare genetics, even if he has other traits that I wouldn't really want to pass on. All right, and Zakir can stay there. Lassie is finally over near him, so they might be able to have a baby together. Hopefully it'd be a really cool looking baby. I guess the risk of having babies is also always that we might get twins, and that would be really interesting. Might make things a little intense. All right, let's have Mama Komila gather up some materials. She's actually got a pretty good thing going for her over on this side, so I think I'm gonna send her son Rodin over there to help collect up materials from here. And then, let's see, Avar will stay nearby, and Winty will gather up the nuts as usual. Can Avar gather up the nuts? Unfortunately, he can't. He might be able to, oh, there's bunnies everywhere. He might be able to gather up stuff from the bunnies though. All right, the permanent nest. I forgot there was another permanent nest hiding back here because it's been over the ridge. Do you see how it's kind of blocked from my line of view? Perfect. All right, jump here, breed, jump there. And then we're gonna get Grandpa Halvor over here to be able to watch over the babies. Whew. All right, smooth moves. Wonderful. And we're trying to keep the population on the tribe down too. So that's working. Two permanent nests is probably gonna help us out a lot. All right, anybody else need to move? Not quite. Let's see, Mooney kind of can move around, maybe dig some stuff up. Let's see if we have any armored bodied babies. That's what we're going for all the way. Right now we only have one, and we're Cora, I'm gonna give you all blue marks so I know that you are one of my precious little armored bodied babies. All right, what do we have here? Big body again? Tata, no! Tata's been reborn, you guys. What am I gonna do? Oh my gosh, why? Tata, and I'm gonna name this little one. Man, she's really lovely looking. Let's name this little one. I'm gonna pick out a new name. How about Lily? Little Lily. And the person who submitted this name says Lily means from the island. And I do like her genetics, and I'm really grateful that none of them have doubled up genetics yet. Tata, we're going to have to keep an eye on. Why are we not ending up with Armored Body? Why is it so hard? Cora, I'm so sorry. You might have to have a lot of babies with your dad. That's going to be really awkward. But I have to keep the Armored Body in, and I want to make sure we have a lot of creatures that have more than just it as recessive, or else we could be in big trouble when it comes to keeping that gene. So, at least I know what I need to do. All right, Camila, you're having some bad luck with that bear. So, is there a rabbit? Yes, I'm going to have you avoid that rabbit, or avoid that bear. And then we've got a crabbit over here, who might become a pretty nice lunch. So Rodin helped out with the crabbit lunch. Avar knows that there are some rabbits ahead, but he's gonna stay near Winty. There we go. And we'll have to wait to see if that rabbit gets any closer. And then what do we have over here? So Cora, you are oh so vitally important. I'm really sorry I might have to have you breed with your dad. It's not personal, trust me. And then let's see, Rossi, Kurodo. I might have to start mixing genetics even closer, and I don't want to, but I might have to because we wouldn't really have a choice. All right. If we hit 30 creatures, I'm going to have to stop and just reevaluate like how we're doing things. So Rari, let's get you back into the nest, my dear. I should have jumped you all the way into the nest. Sorry about that. Going to have you come over here. We're going to have little baby Kurodo come over here. I need to get one of those babies defended. I see that it's not defended, but I can only do so much at one time. All right, and Maddox is going to have more babies. Oh, too many babies. Getting nervous about how many babies there are. All right, we're gonna jump over here. Halvor is going to keep an eye on his little granddaughter, Lily. And really, we've got a lot of creatures that we don't really need to have more babies. But Mooney is carrying that immunity K gene. Phooey. All right, you know what? Mooney and Harvey are going to go on an adventure, and they're going to go around this side, and they're going to go visit with the grandma. We have our lovely little grandma Camila over here. They're going to go visit with her and see what kind of insight she might be able to provide, and if we can get the balance bear off of that permanent nest. All right. Oh, look at the snow. It's really building up so high. Oh my gosh. No idea what we're going to do with all that snow. All right, let's gather up that berry before something else steals it away. And then, oh, look at that! Little Ari and Agriana, who is, like, almost grotesquely pregnant, to be completely honest. Wow, that's actually kind of frightening. It looks so normal from this side, and from this side, it's terrifying. Oh my gosh. But they're having a little bit of a conversation. There's a Dodo Mingo. I'm going to just gather up some of this. I'm going to come down here, gather up some of the grass. Quotimia is going to work on that. Tagai is going to dig up some more roots, I think. There's lots of roots around here that he can actually dig up. That's useful because he clears away all of the snow when he does that too. And then Darren, lucky you, you get to move across the snow and try to go find something to collect. All right. Oh, and little, oh, her mom passed away. Oh, I'm going to name her, let's go with Evergreen. Why not? Somebody submitted the name Evergreen, and I actually think that's quite lovely. She's got great genes. She has immunity K and immunity D, big body, and I really do like keeping that K going, so I'm glad to see K is still there. And Fisk has his H and D. We may have him become her mate, maybe. And we'll have to see where we're going to go with that. But speaking of mates, Lassie is finally here. And she can finally come up just at the edge of Zakai's life. And he can take the mate that he's always, in his dreams, really, really hoped to see. So there we go. Got that little pairing lined up. Sedeli is quite lovely. Her fertility is super low, though, so I think she's going to earn herself a like non-breeder, non-essential mark, and we might move her out depending. Kinka, I really like her. I just can't really justify a lot of her genes. I think I saw that there was a... I think I could have sworn I saw a clamshell over here. But did one of the other creatures like come and steal it? All right, she's going to go looking for clamshells. Oh, and it's the very last day that Raju has with us. I'm going to let him just kind of like rest over here where he can see his beloved waterfall. There we go. And then Fisky, you can go ahead and stay here. Maybe clear away some of the snow just to make sure it stays down. And Sedel, Can you do anything useful? She can kind of fish. Might as well send her over to the waterfall. Oh, and she has frog legs too, so sending her to the waterfall might be a good thing. What do I do? I really want to keep the armored body, but should I just have, like... You know what? I just really want to send all armored-bodied creatures. I'm going to hold my guns there. I'm going to hold my guns, and we're going to have a lot more babies. All right, let's hope for armored body. No! No! Dang it! We have doubled up immunity and armored body! That's a good thing and a really bad thing at the same time! Everybody, evacuate the nest zone! This nest zone is now infected! This is not good! I mean, I knew I was pushing my luck. Good news, we have more armored-bodied females. Bad news, we've got some issues going on. Okay, the plague is going to spread. I need to evacuate the nest site ASAP. This is not good, but the good news is if I can keep these two alive long enough to wiggle their way to a nest spot and maybe bring Fisk over, we might be able to breed them together and we might end up with some babies that have both rare and healthy immunity genes because there's no repeats between Fisk and those now sick females. We're playing with basically genetic dynamite here and the plague all rolled into one on top of a mountainside full of Arctic ram foxes and hot springs and balance bears, but I'm hoping the investment will be worth it because I truly want to get at least 5 fully armored bodied creatures. So armored body is pretty much the only trait that we would carry in with this family, and then send them to the next island. So this could end up being the beginning of a fantastic twist to our legacy, or it could end up being the end of the armored body family as a whole. We're gonna have to see next time. Oh my gosh, I need some new tea to fortify myself for this. This is gonna be intense. Or should I say intense? Pushing it with the puns because I'm excited. But I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.